One of the popular topics these days is the colonization of other planets, humans going from the safety of Earth to set up home on a foreign world. Unfortunately, most of these colonizing endeavors require the new citizens of these foreign worlds to live in protected cities or wear protective clothing at all times, which is cool but arguably less cool than the more expensive, less practical alternative, terraforming. Put simply, terraforming is converting the environment of a planet to make it comfortable for human occupation. So, let's imagine that you are now an eccentric billionaire.
You may need a little more than that.
Trillionaire.
Well...
Money is no object for you, and you have a goal of living in another world. Well, you have 7 planets to choose from and several moons, so let's shorten that list. Terraforming a gas giant is probably not possible, and even if it was, it's probably not worth the effort, so there are to the question. Mercury is dangerously close to the sun, and Mars by this time will probably have a good few colonies on it, and you probably don't want to share your newly acquired planet. So that leaves Venus. Venus is probably the least welcoming place in the solar system, and terraforming it will be no easy task. Venus is hot, its atmosphere is poisonous, it has no magnetic field, and has very long days. But fortune favors the bold and other assortment of inspirational statements, so let's get started. For the purpose of this video, we will consider terraforming to be successful if people are able to walk on the surface of the planet and breathe its atmosphere. There should be no need for consistent protective equipment except in an emergency, and food or water should not be constantly shipped from Earth. So in the case of Venus, we need to drop the temperature, make the atmosphere thinner and breathable, acquire a consistent food and water source, and provide protection from solar radiation. As I said before, Venus is hot. It's actually the hottest planet in the solar system. So the first step to colonizing it would be dropping its temperature from a toasty 480 degrees Celsius to something a bit more comfortable. The pressure at its surface is 90 atmospheres, so it needs to be thinned out so going outside doesn't result in crushed bones or crushed everything. Fortunately, both of these issues are connected. Thinning Venus's atmosphere will also allow for a cooler surface temperature. One of the ways this can be done is by introducing hydrogen using the Bosch reaction. This will create water and elemental carbon, or graphite. This will leave mainly nitrogen, some of which will dissolve in the new oceans. This thinner atmosphere should be much cooler. But where would we get this hydrogen from, you ask? If we're in the business of terraforming planets, it may not be too far-fetched to take the hydrogen from a nearby gas giant. So now the atmosphere is thinner, cooler, and as a useful byproduct, we now have water. But the air still won't be breathable, as most of the oxygen is either in the form of water or in the form of carbon dioxide, neither of which we can breathe. Fortunately, the solution to this problem is right here on Earth. Plants have many cool features such as being edible, which will come in handy later, but the feature we are more interested in is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process that takes carbon dioxide and water and makes oxygen and carbohydrates. Planting on the surface itself might prove difficult because of the rocky nature of the surface, but the new oceans, which would take up about 80% of the planet's surface, will work fine. This would be a perfect place for algae and water plants. This process will take some time to fill the atmosphere to breathable levels, so you can have factories that convert water into hydrogen and oxygen through electrolysis. The oxygen gets released into the air, and the hydrogen can be used to power the colony in conjunction with other sources. Okay, good, surface temperatures are down, the atmosphere is now breathable. Other than the surface being covered with volcanoes, most of your issues have been solved. Except for one. Venus has no magnetosphere, which means that any of the planet's colonists that spends prolonged time outside will have a high cancer risk. They would have to wear protective suits at all times to prevent this, and that's against our terraforming policy. So we need to find a way to get a new magnetic field. Venus doesn't spin fast enough to have a magnetic field. I know what you're thinking. Spin it faster and you'd get a magnetic field. While that may be true, even with your unlimited resources, the resources required to increase the spin of a planet are largely impractical, so we're not going to do that. NASA has proposed that an artificial magnetic field can be put around Mars to protect it. The same concept can be applied to our Venus colony. Of course, this would mean that should this orbital structure be damaged, the entire colony would be at risk. This can be addressed by having building codes ensure that all structures have deep enough basements so individuals can shelter. Prolonged downtime can be addressed by wearing suits till the structure is repaired, and since it's temporary, doesn't break our terraforming policy. Congratulations, you are now the proud owner of the planet Venus. There is a pesky treaty that claims you can't legally own a planet, but that was before anyone could legally own a planet. Needless to say, if they can't take it from you, it's pretty much yours. I hope you enjoyed the video. As usual, sources for everything I talked about are in the description. If you have any corrections or suggestions, feel free to leave me a comment. And if you liked the video and want to see more, subscribing is a really good way to do that.